Okay, so hi everyone. This is Nestor again from Oragon Channel or Oragon Vlog. So today guys, we'll be discussing the salary versus the living expenses for basic jobs like cooks, cleaners, those who work in the hospitality sector, the basic incomes of these workers and the basic income of our fellow nurses here in Australia. So just as a disclaimer guys, so this one will just be giving an approximation of the overall cost of the living expenses and the salary of our fellow nurses and other jobs here in Australia. So the first one in terms of salary, the average monthly salary here in Australia is roughly 3,000 Australian dollars. And as of now, the minimum wage for Australia, which is one of the top salary per hour in the world, is at $19.50. So if you would sum it up, you would probably earn roughly 750 Australian dollars a week, roughly 3 grand in a month. So those are for our basic jobs with minimum wage. These are just basic pay and no penalties and no overtime yet. So roughly 3,000 Australian dollars. But for our fellow nurses, I would roughly estimate, let's say, 5 grand in a month. Okay, so we'll try to stick to those salary, $3,000 and $5,000 for our nurses, and for the basic jobs, 3,000 Australian dollars. When it comes to living expenses, guys, we would be tackling about the five main things that people actually spend here. The first one is accommodation or the rent. So if you'll be coming here in Australia, it would be a good idea to actually do shared accommodation first. My rough estimate, you might actually spend roughly 160 to 180 Australian dollars every week. So that's roughly 720 Australian dollars in a month. Okay, so the next one would be food or grocery. So in a month or in a week, probably you'll be spending roughly 30 to 50 Australian dollars. So my rough estimate would be 200 Australian dollars in a month. Okay, so obviously you have to properly plan your meals for a week or for the next couple of days in order for you to save. The next one would be transportation. So obviously, I'm here in Australia, you don't have any private vehicle yet. So it would be best if you actually walk or take some public transport like buses and trains. If you would live closer to your job, that's great. You can save more money. But my rough estimate would be 30 Australian dollars every week, or roughly 120 Australian dollars in a month for your transportation. The fourth one would be private health insurance. So if you come here as a student or as a worker, you definitely need a basic private health insurance. So that would cost you roughly, I might say 80 to 100 Australian dollars in a month. But you can actually get as low as 80 Australian dollars for a basic private health insurance. And the last one would be the main thing. Obviously, you need a phone when you come here in Australia. You can actually get an average or a decent phone plan for roughly 40 to 50 Australian dollars in a month, with unlimited calls like and texts within Australia and with a good amount of data. So I've actually added in here some extras. It would be safe if you have a buffer of like an extra $200 every month for like if you plan to spend some more money, if you actually eat out with your friends or watch some movies. So if you actually add up all those expenses that I mentioned earlier, you might actually spend roughly 1370 Australian dollars, or roughly 1370 Australian dollars monthly. If you would actually deduct it in a basic kind of job, monthly wage of $3,000, you would still be able to save roughly 1630 Australian dollars, or 1630 Australian dollars monthly. But for our fellow nurses, you might actually be able to save roughly 3630 Australian dollars monthly. So this again is just a rough estimate. Hypothetically, if you've got a 3,000 and 5,000 salary monthly for our nurses and for those basic jobs that I've mentioned earlier. Again, it would be a different story if you wanted your own room the average cost for that in the city would be, if you'll be getting a shared room or your own room in a shared apartment, it might cost you 250 Australian dollars every week or 1 grand in a month. So that would be added to your overall cost. So in my estimate, you would still manage to save 630 Australian dollars if you've got a basic job, or if you've got a $3,000 monthly income, and it would lessen your savings to roughly probably 2,000 plus 2,900 Australian dollars monthly for our nurses. So in conclusion, guys, if you're just starting here as a student or as a worker here in Australia, it would be best if you actually do shared accommodation to limit your overall cost. It would actually generate you more savings, and eventually, after a couple of years of staying here, probably you can do and have your own room. But for the meantime, if you're just about to start, it would be best if you just do a shared accommodation. Second would be, try to prioritize your overall cost, or prioritize your budgeting and stick to your budget. That would make a big difference. And the third one would be, probably do more shifts or do more work so that it would actually generate more income for you. And the last one, the bottom line, is actually please save more. So do save, save, and save. So anyway, guys, these are just some tips for you who's planning of coming here in Australia as a student or as a worker in basic type of jobs, either in hospitality or any basic kind of jobs, and for our fellow nurses. I hope, guys, this video help you a bit to have an idea what's the overall salary and expenses here in Australia. Again, this is Nestor from Oragon Channel, and if you guys like the video, please don't forget to like and subscribe, and I hope I'll see you guys next time. Thanks again for watching.